Hey guys, welcome to my Publisher Rocket review video. Today we're going to go over Publisher Rocket's pros, cons. I'm going to give you a tutorial and also tell you about the pricing and basically if it's worth it, if it can really help you as a self-published author or an author in general. Now, before we get started, I do want to clear up some confusion with the name of this software. It used to be called KDP Rocket. Now it's called Publisher Rocket, and we're going to be reviewing the most updated version of Publisher Rocket in this video. All right, guys, I'm sure you want to see how Publisher Rocket works and how it can benefit you as a self-publisher or an author. Now, before we get started, make sure to stick to the end of the video because I'm going to be offering you a Rocket bonus if you do decide to get Rocket. Those videos are going to be a lot more in-depth than the tutorials shown in this video. It's not going to only explain each feature in Rocket, but it's also going to show you how to apply it to your KDP dashboard and your Amazon Ads platform. Now let's focus in here on Rocket. One of the biggest changes in the latest version is that it switched up its look. As you can see, it looks pretty clean. I'll post up an image here so you can see what it used to look like before. On top of the new change, the speed of this software is a lot faster. If you've been a user, and I have been for a few years now, you can tell the difference. Now let's get started with what's most important here. Now these four tools used to only display ebook data. That's what the old Publisher Rocket used to give you. But this time around, in the latest version, it allows you to sort by or filter by book data. So we all know that paperbacks will give you a better ROI than Kindle books ever will, and a lot of people still buy paperbacks. So this is very important and one of the key features when it comes to Publisher Rocket. All right, so for this example, let's use book data and let's type in a seed keyword here. So let's choose a diet like paleo diet, and then you'll see that Publisher Rocket here brings up all the keywords based on this seed keyword, like the variations. So in order to explain this feature here, let's click on some of these analyze buttons. This way it'll show you the data for the certain keywords that you would probably want to write or rank for on Amazon. Okay, so maybe this one, paleo diet book, sure. Probably one I would want to rank for. Okay, I think these are enough to explain what this Rocket software can do for you. So as you can see here, we got the keywords on the left hand side, we got the number of competitors on the second column, and then the third column is the average monthly earnings for all the books that are ranking for this particular keyword. So don't take this as gospel. It's not 100% accurate whatsoever, but it at least gives you an idea. And you can see right here that the Paleo Diet Cookbook actually makes more money on average than just ranking for paleo diet, because it seems like people want more cookbooks than just a book about the paleo diet and explaining what it is. All right, so next up is the Google searches per month column. So this could be useful for you if you have something like a blog, because if you have a blog alongside your book, then you're going to be able to write blog post content on these keywords as well, and they will eventually rank on Google, and then you can eventually bring that traffic to your book's sales page. So that explains this column there. And then the next one is one of my favorite columns in Publisher Rocket, and it's the estimated Amazon searches per month. So I think that's really cool, and I think that'll give you some real insight on what keyword and or title you were going to name your book, because depending on the title and the keyword that you're aiming for, you might be trying to rank for a keyword that's not bringing in a lot of traffic on Amazon. And if it's not bringing, people aren't typing that keyword in, then you're most likely not going to get a lot of traffic, aka a lot of sales to your book. All right, next up is the competitive score. So this is just a score between 1 and 100 about how difficult it's going to be to rank for a certain keyword. So as you can see, paleo diet for beginners is going to be a lot easier than these first two keywords, but it also has less search volume. It has less than 100. So I'd be probably not going for paleo diet for beginners, although some people do, and that's okay. Paleo diet for diabetes, you can see that the competitive score is 20. Pretty easy, but it's less than 100 in traffic, which brings me to the next feature of Publisher Rocket, which is the competition analyzer. So we can go in here and click this and then search a keyword, but we're already here. So what we're going to do is just stick with this keyword, the one with the 20 competitive score, and click the competition. So this brings us to the competition analyzer. This is one of the features I don't use too much, because I usually just use KD Spy. I'll talk about that more later. I do have a review article for Rocket, and it explains everything that you're seeing in this video, plus a lot more, plus the alternatives to Rocket or competitors to Rocket like KD Spy. But anyways, if you don't have KD Spy, what you can do is actually just view what's on here. So for the paleo diet for diabetics keyword, you can see here in the competition tool that it's going to show you all the competitors on the first page here. And it's also going to give you the type of book. So you can see the ebook data if you want, or you could just stick with the book data. If you click this see ebook data, so if you click the see ebook data, like I was saying here, this one doesn't have an ebook. It just is a paperback. But if you click that see ebook data, it'll switch the numbers here. You can switch back between book and ebook data for this competition screen. Next up, it's the author column and then the age column. So this is basically how many days since it was first published the book is out there. So this is fairly new, 133 days, and this is ranking for number two. Paleo diet cookbooks for diabetics with color pictures. So this is probably not a self-published author, but at least it lets you gauge what you're going up against if you were going to go for this keyword. Now, next up is the Amazon bestseller ranking. This is going to give you a gauge on how much this book sells each and every day. As you can see, the lower the better. This one right here is actually going to be making a lot more sales than any other book on this screen right now. Perhaps not this one. This one's actually a little bit better because it's closer to zero. Now, it'll also tell you if the keyword is in the title or in the subtitle. So for most of these, it's a no. This main keyword is not in the title. So that'll give you some what to do's and what not to do's if you'd like. Now this next column is the estimated daily sales for each keyword. So you can see for this keyword right here, the book makes roughly estimated $248 per day. And the ebook makes roughly around $20 per day. Of course, this is an estimation. These are just guidelines, okay? Next up is the monthly sales. Of course, another estimation here. Now, the paleo for beginners, it looks like it's pulling in the most money. Actually, no, it's this one. Dr. Neil Bernard is pulling in more than 10 grand based off its book sales alone. And you can always switch back and forth. So that is pretty interesting. You can always check it out here. And clicking the check it out link will bring you to the Amazon book sales page. All right, guys, so far we've been covering a lot of benefits, a lot of pros of the publisher Rocket software, but now it's time for a few cons. So one of the cons that a couple of the cons that I didn't like is that you can't filter the columns here for the keyword search tool or the competitor analyzer tool. So if I wanted to filter by age, I can't do that right now. If I wanted to filter by the estimated Amazon searches per month because I wanted to order them from highest to lowest, I can't do that right now, unfortunately. That's something I do wish to see improved, perhaps in the next update. That'd be great. If, for example, you were doing keyword research or using these tools for your own niche, what you can do if you wanted to filter these is export this data here on a CSV or an Excel spreadsheet and use the Excel filter feature. So unfortunately, these are the two cons that I've seen with the latest Publisher Rocket update. All right, moving on to the second to last feature we're going to cover, and that is category search here on Rocket. And this is one of the most important features. The reason being is because it helps you better optimize your book to achieve the best seller logo by your book on the Amazon search results. So when somebody types in a keyword or a keyword variation and your book shows up, and if it has this by your book, then this is going to increase your click-through rate to your book. Overall, it's going to increase your traffic, thus increase your sales. So Rocket's going to help you optimize this a lot better than if you didn't have it. And the reason I say that is because Amazon no longer shows the category strings. So in the past, what Amazon did was it used to show the strings of a book category. So you were able to go to a competitor's sales page and scroll down, go to see what categories he's chosen for his book. And for example, let's say he was ranking number one for this linguistics category, then you would also want to choose that same category or set of categories that he had in order to rank your book and overtake that number one spot and get that bestseller logo by your book. But Amazon no longer does that. So what Amazon does instead is it just provides the very last section of this category string. as you can see here. So what Rocket does is it shows those strings. So let me show you exactly what I mean here by typing in our seed keyword paleo diet. So it seems like the keyword paleo diet wasn't in a category string, but that's okay. We can just narrow it down to paleo and then click on, let's do ebooks this time around. And as you can see, there's three categories that show up for paleo, one actually being from a different niche. So we could ignore this third row. So for this specific paleo diet category, you can see that it takes 15 Kindle book sales per day to achieve the number one spot. And once you have that number one spot, you can get that bestseller orange logo by your book. And what I like about this feature is that you can actually sort the columns. I love that. Because there's actually some categories, for example, the broader category of paleo would be weight loss, right? And when it comes to your niche or a bigger category than just paleo diet, for example, this keyword weight loss, it's very helpful to have a filter feature just like this one. So you can really pick and choose strategically which categories are going to be easier for you to get number one on. And by the way, guys, you can choose more than three categories for your books. You can actually choose up to 10. So I'm going to talk about how to do that here in just a few moments. But first, let's cover AMS keyword search. All right, let's cover the last very useful feature of Rocket, which is called the AMS keyword search. And we're going to type in our seed keyword here for ebooks. All right, so as you can see, Rocket's AMS feature has compiled a whole bunch of keyword suggestions that you can actually bid on the Amazon Ads platform, and it sourced these keywords through different methods. So one of the first ones are Amazon suggestions. So these are pretty self-explanatory. These are just other keywords that are in the niche as well. And the Amazon A to Z suggestions were sourced from the Amazon search engine, which basically means Rocket just typed in paleo diets and all the variations from A to Z in the search bar and compiled them on this screen right here for you. So there's different sources that Rocket gets its data from. And as you can see, it even sources related keywords in your niche based off of other people's books. And you can see that here. The last thing I want to say about this feature is that now in the latest update, there's a filter button, which is amazing because in the past, what you had to do is you would have to export this out and then go row by row and delete rows manually because some keywords were just not a good fit for what you wanted to target in your Amazon Ads campaign. So instead now, what you can do is filter through a lot of different things. So let's say in this data report, you don't want author names or you don't want similar books like at all. You can just uncheck these and not have them. But it's really up to you and dependent on the niche. You know your niche a lot better than me. But once you set your filter, let's just say we don't want these author names and ASIN numbers, you can just filter them by Rocket, and then Rocket just filters and compiles the new set of data for you. So that's a pretty cool feature. It's actually quite useful and it'll help you in your Amazon ads if you're doing them now or if you plan on doing them in the future. All right, guys, thanks for watching my publisher Rocket review video. In conclusion, Rocket is going to give you a lot more ROI than if you were not to get it. Eventually, you're going to need some type of keyword research tool for Amazon. You're going to want your competitive edge over your competition when it comes to showing up higher in the search results or showing up for those keyword variations that we talked about in the tutorial. So right now it's priced at $97. It's a one-time payment. There's no upsells, there's no monthly recurring fees, and there's a 30-day money-back guarantee. So I think it's definitely worth getting at that price just to optimize your books, get that competitive edge, and also optimize your Amazon ads, which will in turn make you a lot more money. Now, what you're looking at here on your screen is my Publisher Rocket review article. I've been keeping this article updated since 2017, since I first started using this tool back when it was called KDP Rocket. So I'm gonna leave a link to this article in the description, so make sure to check it out. If you are watching my Rocket review video in the future and an update comes up, make sure to check this link because it's gonna be kept updated as Rocket evolves and keeps getting better and better. And make sure to get it at the one-time price because I have a feeling eventually one day Dave is going to make this a monthly recurring software. And last but not least here, I do want to tell you about the Publisher Rocket bonus that I'm giving away. If you do decide to get Publisher Rocket through any link on this article that you're seeing here, you're going to get the following four bonuses. Number one is optimizing your KDP book settings with Rocket data. So that's making sure both your book settings are optimized specifically for the keywords that Rocket found for you. Number two is optimizing your book description for Amazon SEO. This is a little bit technical, but we're going to optimize your description a little bit based off the Rocket data that we collected as well. Number three is how to get 10 categories instead of 3 categories. So this is going to increase your chances of getting that orange bestseller logo by your book. And the fourth bonus is my AMS case study that I'm doing here, and it's currently in progress. So if you do want to get these bonuses along with your Rocket purchase, make sure to go to my article, get Rocket through any link on this page, and then send me a message with this button here and tell me that you got Publisher Rocket based off my review and I'd like my bonuses, and I'll gladly give them to you. Anyways, that's it for my Rocket review, guys. I hope you guys liked it. Let me know what you think in the comments. If you have any questions, like, comment, subscribe, and I will talk to you in the next video.